Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
For this task, I'm going to be showing you how to title your rows and columns in Excel. And this is really important when you're moving around in a data sheet or a table, because it helps orient you where you are when you're just moving through a sea of numbers. For example, I can move here with the arrow keys through my example budget spreadsheet.
Utilities, C blank, C6, utility, groceries, D7, entertainment, E7.
And you can hear that I'm at the top of the columns here. So of course, if I down arrow once,
$79.00, entertainment, E7.
And then up arrow, I know that that $79 is in the entertainment column. But as I move through this table, and I move away from this top row.
$79.00, $225.00, $80.00, C10.
And I'm just arrowing around, getting a feel for this spreadsheet. But very quickly, I lose track of where I am, which column, whether it's groceries, utilities, rent, entertainment. So I want to label these columns so that when I move into them, I'm told where I am. I have a reference of where I am in the spreadsheet. I'm going to arrow up to where all the column titles are.
$1,002, rent, B7.
There we go. And I can select this with shift space.
Select A7, blank, XFD7, blank.
So that means this entire row will be designated as my column titles for this table. And the keyboard commands you'll need to designate these as column titles is Alt Control Insert C. And it's quite a bit of finger work, but well worth it once you get it done. So I'm going to hold down Control Alt Insert and then tap the letter C.
Setting column titles row range to 7.
All right. So now when we arrow around, you'll hear something a bit different. Let me show you.
Blank, A7. January, 8, rent, $1,200.00, B8.
Ah, nice.
Utilities, $75.00, C8.
So we're arrowing through this table and our columns are all labeled. And what we are able to hear now when we arrow into that column is the title of it, no matter where we are. Now, if I know what column I'm in and I press down arrow,
$80.00, C9,
I don't hear it again. But if I press right arrow and move to another column,
groceries, $225.00, D9,
I'm told which column I'm in. All right, now let's do the same for these rows. I'm going to left arrow over to where the months are listed.
Utility, rent, February.
And I'm going to press control space.
Select A1, blank, A1,048,000.
Because you don't have to do it this way. You can select just the ones you want to designate. But for this example, I'm just selecting this entire column to designate this column as where the row titles will appear. So to designate these as row titles, I will press Alt Control Insert R. Again, quite a bit of finger work, but you'll hold down Alt, Control, Insert, and I'll tap the R.
Setting row titles column range to A.
So now that I have my rows and columns both titled, I'm going to arrow down through my budget spreadsheet so that you can hear the way that they're read.
January, 8-8.
I'm going to right arrow from here.
Rent. $1,200.00, B8.
And if you remember before, when we labeled our columns, we would only hear the announcement when we changed columns. So we were using left and right arrow. And when we did that, we changed columns and the column title was announced.
Utilities, $75.00,
just C8. Like that. For row titles, those will be announced when you use up and down arrow to move between rows. So we know right now that we are in the utilities column. If we press down arrow here,
February, $80.00, C9.
We hear the utilities for February were 80. But since we haven't changed columns, we didn't hear that announced again. If I press right arrow again,
groceries, $225.00, D9.
I hear groceries for February were $225, and if I down arrow
March blank D10,
March appears to be blank. Let's up arrow.
February $225.00 D9, January $200.00 D8.
So we hear that groceries in January were $200. And that is how you label rows and titles in Excel, a definite necessity if you're working with large spreadsheets.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.